hunger strike, let alone an extended 50-day water-only hunger strike, is probably on the scale of things to do, not the easiest of things. Maybe one of my best indications of that is the continued concern and fear of the Secret Service in the park that have some considerable regard for me and the work that I do. To do it with no physical support, even residents, no logistical support or care, physical assistance, opportunity to sleep afterwards, logistical help in terms of food and proper nutrition, and almost complete lack of compassion in an environment that is considerably hostile, probably makes it quite a bit tougher. Given that, maybe it's remarkable how well I'm doing, and not surprising that I'm sure I'm experiencing some level of depression. I can't tell, somewhere between mild and severe. To move from such a totally devoted pursuit, such tremendous focus, to an awareness of such profound lack of support, such profound lack of response, such profound deadness in society, it's odd, because it's important to understand that I did it knowing those things. I did it despite those things. I did it to try and remedy those things. I did it with no expectation of return. And yet, it's as though one is, as I've done often in my life, clapping wildly in support of someone that you, who you really want to feel the support. Long and hard, even exhausting. And then when you stop, realizing that there's total silence. No one else is clapping alongside of one. No one else is providing the support. No one else is infusing the energy. It's not that the clapping was done with the thought of any of that, but nonetheless, it becomes evident in the absence. This definitely is adding to the depression that I'm feeling, as is my sense of illness and wound in my body. I share none of this by way of complaint. How am I to know how our Father wants to use me? I think it's moving me His way in such a loveless, godless world. I had thoughts today, maybe more clearer than ever before, of wanting to be with Him, wanting to turn my life over to His care, a disinterest in what He decides to do with me, sickness and starvation, destitution, ridicule may be what He has in store, and I think I'm okay with that. Apparent abject failure may be what He has in store, and I'm okay with that. It is, there's no indication He'll ever ask me, as long as He gives me breath, to stop fighting for humanity with every breath I've got, and I have no inclination to do so, quite the opposite. I find salvation, I believe salvation is in devotion to our brothers and sisters, particularly when it's dark. Particularly when they're the least supportive or most hateful. And my thought is not to go and crawl away in our Father somehow for solace, but that is the direction that solace is in such a cruel, heartless world. One can try and stand alone, or one can at least realize they're standing with our Father and take whatever consequences may come. And I suppose standing with our brother Christ Jesus. But I thought it was important to report the depression, if not the major depression that I'm undergoing right now, because those that also contemplate hunger strike, even if they have a massive support network, I suspect can expect that at the end of a long and physically challenging, arduous, uncomfortable, fatiguing hunger strike.